What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at again with another video. So, we're gonna check out the opening segment to Monday Night Raw with Brock Lesnar. Now, some of you guys were hitting me up on Instagram saying, yo, I need to check this out. This segment was pretty cool. So, that's what we're here for. The road to SummerSlam is upon us. How can they make this feud somewhat better? I know a lot of us are tired of seeing this match. How can they make this even better? Are they going to intensify their interactions? What's going to be said? I've made this claim. The only way this match really works for me is if they go out there and literally try to murder each other on pay-per-view. That's the only thing that I can honestly say that would make this match work. They need to try to end each other legit, goddammit. I need to see blood. I need to see flaming tables. I need to see carnage. Let's see if we get a little prelude to the potential carnage at SummerSlam. Appreciate all the love and support. Let's do the damn thing.
Well, God bless Texas.
What the hell?
With an intro like that, it'd be rude for me to leave my hat on this evening. I'll show you all some manners. Thank you very much.
Bro, Brock, you can tell he's just having fun, dog. I can't get mad at that.
As we just saw, life is good for Roman Reigns.
Hear the boos. Hear the boos. As you should.
You see, since WrestleMania, Roman's been living high on the hog.
Mm-hmm.
Flying in private jets, eating like a king. I think there's an old saying, and it came from right here in Texas. Pigs get fat and hogs get slaughtered.
Oh. Oh. You're talking about somebody
Roman
getting slaughtered
Reigns,
here. Okay. Talking to the camera.
You're a hog.
Uh-oh.
And I slaughter hogs on my farm.
This is what he actually does.
Every single day.
This is actually what he does.
At SummerSlam, the tribal hog.
Oh no, the tribal hog
is gonna get a country chicken.
Mm. Got away with one S-bomb.
To the likes he's never seen.
I want to see blood.
Gentlemen.
Uh-oh.
Oh, what an unpleasant
boy.
Surprise for Lesnar.
You suck, Chance. Very loud, you suck, Chance.
Listen, despite our differences, Brock Lesnar does not suck. Odds on favorite. If you're a betting man, who are you betting on for SummerSlam in a last man standing match? Brock Lesnar.
Brock's not winning.
Why?
That match.
Because
he's not
Roman
winning that match.
Reigns defined his greatness by athletically beating down, smashing the opposition, pinning them, making them tap out in athletic competition. But we, for 20 years, we defined Brock Lesnar's legacy by annihilating people, by putting them down for good, by taking them out of action, by breaking their necks, by conquering streaks, by ending careers. So if Brock Lesnar has to put Roman Reigns down for the count of 10, that's what Brock Lesnar is going to do.
The one thing I can always say about Paul, he knows how to build up your opponent. He's really good at that. That's a skill. He can build up your opponent, but also still talk down to you. He can make you feel like $1 million, but he's still, you know, like, yeah, you're fantastic. Future Hall of Famer, all these great things. But you're not going to beat Roman. And I've always liked that about Paul.
It doesn't matter to Brock Lesnar if he puts Roman Reigns down for 10. He puts Roman Reigns down for 100. He doesn't care if he sends Roman Reigns to the hospital or if he sends Roman Reigns to the morgue.
Hey, man, I'm all for the violence.
That's not a man. That's a beast. That's a hog slaughterer. That's an annihilator. That is an avenging badass that wants revenge. Is one streak you will not conquer. I have to train Roman Reigns to stick his hand up your ass and pull your heart out through that hole. That is what my tribal chief is going to do.
Roman at home like, hey, yo, Paul, I ain't trying to stick my hand up on nobody's ass. Like, what? I'm just trying to beat him. What the fuck? Like, what are you talking about? I'm sticking my hand up his ass. Like, what do we? No. Okay. All right.
To something like you.
That was interesting.
Did you just say,
go, let's go. Oh.
There's money in the bank in the house.
In WWE history, I'm going to take back my United States Championship from Bobby Lashley, and then I'm going to sit back and watch this match of mass destruction. Walk down to the ring, holding my contract high, cashing in my contract, and either putting my foot on your chest or Roman Reigns' chest.
Well, why don't you come down here right now and let's go?
Definitely not doing that.
You know what, Brock? It doesn't matter if you win or Roman Reigns wins, because the way you two are talking about the outcome, it's going to be life-altering. Brock Lesnar doesn't give a damn about anybody but himself. He doesn't care about anybody's life but his own.
I ain't going to lie to you. He killed Austin Theory. He sent him to the gulag. He just threw him off the top of the cell pod. I've never seen that spot. Austin Theory died that night. Now he's revived from the ashes of the Hell Elimination Chamber. But still, he killed him that night. Oh my!
Roll the footage.
He killed him at Elimination Chamber, bro. Oh my god. Oh my god. This was brutal, bro. Look at this.
Tossing the lifeless carcass. Steel Foundation.
I did not deserve this. That was brutal.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Shut up! Mr. Heyman, that footage, that could be Roman Reigns. I mean, he could be just a heap of human flesh sitting there, emotionless. But that footage wasn't just for you to tell the Roman Reigns about. It's actually also for you. Because you see, Brock, I showed you that to remind you that I didn't forget.
Brock doesn't give zero fucks.
Brock Lesnar comes to town and all the cockroaches show up.
What are they doing?
Former tag champions.
Look at the
tree. Oh, no. Lesnar is smiling at the tree trunk.
What are they doing?
The mass of humanity.
Oh,
baby.
We're about to see this, gentlemen.
Oh,
the tree trunk and the lumberjack.
Right.
Can I say rest in peace to them, bro? Rest in peace. Before I even watch this, rest in peace. You guys are done. He's going to slaughter you like goddamn hogs. We're about to.
Right. Get in, boys.
The beast incarnate almost salivating.
Oh, Gable.
Gable
from behind. 2-on-1. Lesnar still on his feet.
No effect.
Oh, my God.
No effect at all.
Oh, my God, bro.
And now the beast becoming unleashed.
Oh, no.
Out goes Gable.
And that was.
Out goes, oh,
quick work with him. Otis, unbelievable. It was just quick work with him. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, you shouldn't have listened to Austin Theory. Oh, oh, he's dead. Oh. Oh, my gosh, bro. Send some officials out there. Please, someone stop this. Please, someone stop this. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh! 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 Oh, my God. Delivered to Otis. Oh, no. Lesnar. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Cameraman almost got wiped out. I just want to see Carnage at SummerSlam. That's it.
That nigga dead.
I told you, rest in peace. Rest in peace, Otis.
And we still got a hell of a lot of stuff to get through, Jimmy. And we're just getting started. Theory, of course, obsessed right now.
Oh, man. That was great. That was fantastic. I enjoyed that. I enjoyed that. The only thing I care about is the Carnage. Theory does have he has a very strong point. Y'all gonna kill each other. And I can just pick up the pieces. So we'll see how that plays out. But I'm gonna be honest with you, this Carnage, it needs to be ramped up. I need to see them literally all over the arena. I need to see this last man standing needs to just be all over the arena, everywhere. There needs to just be Carnage. That's the only thing I care about to make this match work. So, but we will see how it play out. So comment down below. Let me know. Did this bring any more excitement to the match? Or are you still in that camp that's saying, yo, I don't give a damn what they do. I'm over this. Did this increase your intrigue just a little bit? Let me know down below. But I appreciate all love and support. Road to 90K. Appreciate y'all. KQB. See y'all next week. Peace.